Karen's story graced this world with love, life, and a song.
One of God's truly talented people.
I've never really copied anybody or styled myself after anybody. See, the way my voice showed up was kind of an accident in the first place. I didn't know that I could sing or do anything until I was about 16 years old.
Every time you start a song, everyone keys a different feeling on somebody. And they all seem to be very important, and people don't forget.
A hometown girl who had made good.
You've been known as the squeaky clean brother and sister.
That's
How do you
right.
react to that? I mean, is that really what you're like?
We're not squeaky,
image.
But we're clean. We're clean.
I get goosebumps thinking about how beautiful she sang. She was like an angel.
Karen Carpenter died of cardiac arrest last Friday.
She was 32 when she died last Friday, apparently of heart failure, although the coroner's office still has not determined the exact cause of death.
Medical examiners have still not established an exact cause of death, but they do say that she died of cardiac arrest.
Spokesman for the family said that Ms. Carpenter had battled anorexia nervosa for years.
That is the psychological disorder which results in self-starvation.
My family, friends, and I realized that as early as 75, the victim, a lot of times, does not realize it as of herself.
Now her life has become a song for the world. About 1,500 of her fans waited for hours outside the Downey United Methodist Church. Her closest friends were there too, singers Olivia Newton-John and Dionne Warwick, and her brother Richard Carpenter had a lot of hugs for friends at the service.
There's one funeral that I didn't want to miss.
I cannot believe she's gone. 32 years old, Karen did not drink, she did not smoke. She never touched drugs, and here she is gone.
She has left a very strong imprint, and that's damn good in your life. She has a very strong place and will always have it